In this illustration, we'll analyze the particles diverging after elastic collision. Here we are given that a particle of mass m collides elastically with another particle of mass 2m at rest with some impact parameter such that after collision the two particles diverge symmetrically. So here we are required to find the angle of divergence. So if we analyze the situation, it is given that there is a particle of mass 2m which is at rest and another particle of mass m is coming at a speed u and it strikes this 2m in such a way that the two particles after collision m here moves say with a speed v1 and 2m moves here say with a speed v2. And it is given that the two particles diverge symmetrically, that means both diverge at the same angle theta. Here we are required to find the value of theta. So, as the collision is elastic, we can conserve momentum and energy. So, here we can write by momentum conservation, initially the ball was coming at a speed u. And finally, the balls are moving at a speed so v1 and v2. So, here we can write the momentum conservation equation along and perpendicular to motion or along the initial direction and final direction of motion. In either ways, we can solve it. Say we write equation along x direction and y direction. Here, if we write the equation along x direction, then we can write it as mu is equals to final momentum in x direction as mv1 cos theta plus 2mv2 cos theta, which is say our equation 1. And along y direction as the initial momentum was 0. So, final must also be 0. So, we can write mv1 sin theta is equals to 2mv2 sin theta, which gives us v1 is equals to 2v2, say this is our second equation. And also we can write by energy conservation, the initial energy of system was half mu square. And for elastic collision, final energy must be same. So, this is half mv1 square plus half 2m multiplied by v2 square. If we substitute the value of v1 as 2v2, here you can see this m gets cancelled out and we are getting u square is equals to v1 square. We can write as 2v2 whole square plus 2v2 square, this equals to 6v2 square. This implies the value of v2 we are getting is u by root 6 and the value of v1 is twice of v2, so it is 2u by root 6. These values can also be obtained if we conserve linear momentum along the direction of theta, where we can write mu cos theta is 2mv2 and mu cos theta is mv1. This relation of equation 2 can also be obtained by using this. And now we can continue from here. By using equation 1, we can write from equation 1, we'll be having u is equals to v1 plus 2v2 cos theta. So this v1 plus 2v2 multiplied by cos theta. So, if we substitute the values of v1 and v2 here, you can see this gives us u is equals to, this is 2u by root 6 plus 2u by root 6, this is 4u by root 6 times cos theta, and here u gets cancelled out and the value of cos theta we are getting is equals to root 6 by 4, or it can also be written as root 3 by 2 root 2. So, we wish to find out the divergence angle. Divergence angle in this situation can be written as theta d, which is twice of theta, or it can be written as twice of cos inverse of root 3 by 2 root 2, this will be the final result of this problem.